get distracted by what goes on, and they get hurt by someone who said that you are not anybody. Use words that really hurt each other. But I didn't come to bring those kind of words today. I came to say I love all of you because we're all part of the same body. Hallelujah. I just may be a little bit darker than you, that's all. But if you cut me, we both bleed red. We both bleed red. We all bleed red. Hallelujah. We still gonna bleed the same way. Hallelujah. And it's the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah. Tonight, I just want to, let me tell you just a little bit about myself. My background in one of, I came from a preacher's kid and all that good stuff. You know, I know some people may have that testimony. But I didn't come that route. I came from a family, as they call it, dysfunctional.
Come on, Pastor.
Of course, all of us probably came from a dysfunctional family. Amen. But my dad was an alcoholic, and my mother was trying real hard to raise 8 children in 1 3-room house. I didn't say 3-bedroom, 3-room house. All the kids slept in 1 room, and my mom had her own room. Which was a combination, you know, like, yeah, living room, dining room, husband, living room, bedroom. So we all lived in one house. And I was brought up that way. And I went into the military when I got out of high school because my mom said, you're going to do something or you're getting out of here. I don't know if y'all have the kind of parents anymore that tell you, you know, lay down the law, say you're going to do something. So I went into the military. After the military, I met my lovely wife, who was from the same hometown. She lived over across this, you know, they call it across the bar, which is a body of water. And I lived in town. You know, I lived in town. But they had a lot of food on their side, and we didn't have very much because my mom was trying to feed 8 children. But anyway, we went through the military, and she did 24 years in the military. I have done some years in the military. I've done the Army. I did a couple years in the Army. I've actually worked as a civilian, government civilian worker. So I'm a working pastor. Amen. Can I get amen?
Amen?
I said, can I get an amen? Amen. It is hard to do, I know. Pastor, I know it. You know it's hard to do. And like I say, I've met my wife and came, we traveled all over through the military. The last assignment we had overseas was Naples, Italy. And we were in Naples, Italy for 3 years, 4 years, and then we came here to the great city of San Antonio.
Amen.
Well, I met all these great, lovely people. Oh, beautiful people look over here on this side. And look on, now y'all look on this side. You know those great, beautiful people out there on this side. And I have served with many different churches in many different areas of ministry. I have been from a lay person all the way up to an assistant pastor before I became a pastor. I worked right alongside some great pastors who did many different things, even overseas. I did a lot of work in ministries. I was a first ordained deacon in Alaska, North Pole, Alaska. It is a city called North Pole. Look it up, it's called North Pole, Alaska. And under the leadership there, and as I came on to San Antonio and we began to go to different services here, and I began to keep up my promise of God, I was going to help whatever you ask me to help. When I go into a church, I don't offer my title first, I offer my hands first. Whatever my hands can do, let my hands do that. The rest will come. Your gift will make room for you. So everybody's not called to be a pastor or a deacon. The church still needs your gift. They still need you. They need administrators. They need deacons. They need somebody to clean. They need all of these things within the church. So, in June of 2013, me and two other families, my wife and two other families, we got together after we had just come out of ministry, and we decided, as the Lord had led me, to start Covenant Restoration Christian Fellowship. And it has been a ride ever since. And it brings me to where I am today, right here in front of you. Who would have thought that a young man all the way from a little town called Faraday, Louisiana, would be standing before you in San Antonio, speaking the word of God.